everyone. I wanted to talk to you today about Botox. My friend from Kathy's Beauty Care Chats did a great video. If you haven't seen it, please, I'll link it below. Go over and watch it. She's going to cover a bunch of points. Hopefully I won't be redundant. We have talked about Botox and we helped each other on the journey of stopping Botox, which was not an easy journey. And I want to talk to you about that. I have had Botox for about 15 years, and I wanted to share some of my thoughts today. I would not have stopped it if it were not for getting 4 autoimmune diseases. Last fall, I had a body breakdown, and it coincided with a few other things when I got my autoimmune. My autoimmune was caused with food, but I had a lot of stress, I had lack of sleep, and I got Botox. Botox is a toxin. If you are not healthy, you can't be thinking that you're going to be able to handle putting toxins in your system. And to explain to you how addictive Botox is, my doctor told me to not get more Botox until I was healthy. In February of this year, after I was told that, I went out and I got some more, because we were going to Maui in March and I wanted to look fresh for my anniversary. I know, crazy. That's how addictive it is. It's beautiful to have an extremely flat, smooth forehead. I love it. It's wonderful. But you are putting a toxin in your body. And I also want to talk about how it's either your forehead lines or your eyelids. Your lines or your lids. It's one or the other. And I'm going to insert a bunch of pictures here of various people, some from Hollywood, just various pictures that I found, where they have beautiful, smooth foreheads and hooded lids. It is very, very hard to get Botox and not have your lids drop. And this is something most people are not aware of, and we're getting so used to seeing flawless lines on people's foreheads that everybody thinks that they have to get it. I now realize, after a withdrawal period, that the flawless lines are not everything. And I'm going to talk about some things that I think are much more important to have than those flawless lines, one of which will be your health. But it took a long time of looking in the mirror, and Kathy and I were holding each other's hand through the withdrawal. I would be okay with how I looked one day, and then I'd wake up and I'd look in the mirror the next and I'm like, I can't do it anymore. I gotta go get some Botox. And you had to let that feeling pass and get used to the new look. You do have lines in your forehead. That's natural, that's normal. And it is a process to get used to it. It feels uncomfortable. I felt like I looked old looking at my forehead with lines at first. This is my natural forehead. I don't think my lines are that bad. Now, I am going to tell you of a couple of tricks that I use to minimize those lines. But I just want to really emphasize that in our society today, we get so used to seeing smooth foreheads, but we don't realize the hooded lids are frequently caused from smooth lines. So it's a trade-off, your lines or your lids. And I now love having my lids, which I've gotten from a few other things as well. So let's get into the things that I do instead. I truly believe our Girulene is like Botox in a bottle. I get mine from The Ordinary. It's not only the best price, but I think it's the best strength. And it leaves your, it's not that I don't have lines, it's that it's like I have a filter. It's like a filter on your camera where it's kind of smoothed them out. And I am very comfortable with how I look. I put it on between my eyebrows, all the way up to my forehead, along my lines at the top of my up here. And the reason that I do that is those are all your strong muscles. And I go all across my forehead. And I'm very careful above my eyes because you don't want it to drop. And I will explain in a minute where not to put our Girulene. I also put it down on the outside of my face along my crow's feet. That is all that I do. Mary Ellen also does her marionette lines. I don't want to have my cheeks fall and I want to keep them up. So I'm not doing that at this time. I might at some point. Mary Ellen's had amazing results. She looks beautiful. I'll link her channel as well. She hasn't had her cheeks fall. I'm a little nervous about that because I have pretty strong lines in my forehead, in my nasolabial area, and I just don't want to risk it. And when I talk about risking things, I am going to insert some pictures where I was trying it underneath my eyes. In my tear duct area, I have had Botox in the past. So I thought I would try Argireline for all those lines under there. It made my face droop, a bloodhound. I had droopage on my cheeks. When I stopped it, it took about 2 weeks to go away. So if you do anything with Argireline you don't like, stop it and wait 2 weeks and it'll go away. But definitely be careful putting it anywhere that you don't want to soften and have droop. Just the same way as the Botox lines on your forehead cause your lids to droop, Argireline is not that strong, so it doesn't cause my lids to droop. The other thing I do to help me have lids is my derma rolling, which I'm a huge believer in, and I'll link that video below. Rather than having the lines that nobody probably even notices, like I said, people see you animated and they see you talking and they see the whole package. People don't focus on your forehead lines the way that we do when we look in the mirror. What I think is more important is having good skin texture. And for that, it's tretinoin, which I'll link below. I get it from All Day Chemist, and vitamin C. And I also love the Ordinary Niacinamide. I think that's another good one for texture. And I've done a video on my acids and peels, and I think that helps tremendously. And the BHA peel from The Ordinary helps a lot in closing up your pores, cleaning them out, and just leaving you with a really beautiful skin texture. I think those things are more important. And I just wanted to open up the dialogue and hopefully give somebody awareness that it is a trade-off between your lines and your lids. And now when I watch television, I realize how many people have smooth foreheads, but they have the hooded lids. And I've chosen to go the opposite route, not only for my health and my pocketbook, but I like the look that I have better. You may disagree, and I'd be very interested to know, are you getting Botox, going to get Botox, thinking about quitting Botox, never had Botox? I'd love to hear where you're at, and if you realize that lines versus lids was a trade-off or not. Thank you so much for spending some of your time with me. I always appreciate it, and I hope you have an amazing day. We'll talk to you next time. I've been talking. Hold on. You guys are crooked.